I think that the crossover bands prevented the hardcore scene from further stagnation.
It was an interesting time. Like people almost had to figure out who they were all over again. And some people left it behind, and some people again went back into this like pure hardcore mode. And then there's people who just embraced the crossover. And it's like, it's music. There's great bands, there's shit bands. There's people being honest about this. There's people who are faking it. And I'm gonna like what I like, and that's it.
Any sort of innovation is just important for the scene, because you're bringing in new influences and it keeps the music fresh and exciting. I think that purist music is great, but when it's done year after year after year, it's more of homage and a form of nostalgia or a tribute to the good old days than doing something that's really innovative and fresh and exciting and inspiring.
Kill 'Em All was the type of album where I know every motherfucker said to themselves, oh, I wish I could fucking write a song and do vocals over that riff, you know what I mean, or do something with that. And I think a lot of people, you know, try to make that happen. And that's why metal and hardcore came together.
You know, I gotta give credit to all the metalheads who first started coming around, because it wasn't really the most welcome place for them back then. You know, you came to a hardcore show with long hair and a bunch of metal bands on your jacket or whatever, you know, you might have some issues. Props to those kids who did make the transition, you know, definitely. You know, and then bands that really made a big difference from the metal world, who started infiltrating, if you will, and actually started making a lot of friends on the scene, were, you know, bands like Carnivore, Nuclear Assault.
Well, basically the first person who turned me on to New York hardcore was Scott Ian, because he got me into Agnostic Front, simultaneously getting me into stuff like Discharge and aggressive, you know, English hardcore and everything. I found it very appealing because at that time, thrash metal was starting to get big and I was really getting into all that. We were all searching for something more intense. You know, we loved Slayer and stuff like that. But when I found out that there was this other parallel scene of intense music right under my nose at CBGB's, I had to go check it out.
I just think that the whole energy of New York hardcore, right, the attitude of New York hardcore is what people were attracted to. It wasn't necessarily the bands as much as it was the energy of the fans.